A journey to the Himalayas, trekking to one of the most remote and inhospitable places in this world, crossing deep gorges and holy mountains. My name is George, and I am here at the start of this magical trip with three of my friends, Lucas, Chu, and Joe. We are going to Goecha La, a mountain pass between India and Tibet, at an altitude of 5,000 meters above sea level. My destination is in Sikkim, a tiny state in the northeast corner of India. I start from Kolkatta, cross the towns of Siliguri and Jothang to reach Yuksam, the trekking hub of Sikkim. Vast stretch of flat land, nourished by rivers which originate from the melting glaciers of the Himalayas. The northern plains, also known as the Indo-Gangetic Plain, spreads over northern India and virtually all of Bangladesh. This fertile plain is named after the Indus and the Ganges, the twin river systems which drains it. After traveling for more than 15 hours across the plains, I reach Siliguri. It is a whole chaos, with horns blasting my ears. The lifeline of Sikkim, Teesta River, rose down the deep gorge. After 2 hours of travel on four-wheel drive, I reached the first town in Sikkim, Jorthang. Jorthang is the hub to West Sikkim. Four-wheel drive vehicles connect every nook and corner of Sikkim from Jorthang. The vacant streets of the town get jam-packed during Sunday's markets. These make shift markets on the roadsides cater the needs of people living in West Sikkim. From Jothang, I moved to Yuksam, the trekking hub of West Sikkim. Sikkim is the least populous state in India. Geographically diverse due to its location in the Himalayas, climate ranges from subtropical to high alpine. The Lepcha people, the original inhabitants of Sikkim, call their homeland Nai Mai El or Paradise, while the Bhutias call it Beul Temasong or the Hidden Valley of Rice. These beautiful mountainous landscape and scattered hamlets resemble more Tibetan than Indian. After traveling for 3 hours, I reached the end of road at Yuksam. This road continues as a trekking trail to the base of Mount Kangchenjunga. Sikkim consists of three major ethnic groups: the Lepchas, the Bhutias, and the Nepalis. Each of the groups has their own language, culture, and dance forms. Shoe fat dance, performed to worship the holy mountain, still prevails among Lepchas. This little town of Yuksam lives on agriculture and tourism.
What are you doing?
Major produce include maize and potatoes, and food pattern is mostly Tibetan. Tourism is a booming business at Yuksam. Mr. MB, the guide most preferred by tourists, works as a tourist guide during the tourist season and works in his fields during the off-season. Yuksam was the first capital of the Kingdom of Sikkim, established in 1642. The first monarch of Sikkim was Phunso Namgyal. He was coronated at this spot near Yuksam, known as Throne of Norbugang.
Our king was Buddhist. वो तो मैं मेडिटेशन करने के लिए वहाँ जाता है और पूजा करने के लिए इधर दुबदी में जाता है वो दुबदी नाचने
लेप्चास वर फॉलोअर्स ऑफ शामानिज्म अकॉर्डिंग टू द लेजेंड बुद्धिस्ट सेंट गुरु रिम्पोचे विजिटेड सिक्किम इन द 19th सेंचुरी ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बुद्धिज्म एंड फोरटोल्ड द एरा ऑफ मोनार्क व्हेन आई स्पिन दीस प्रेयर व्हील्स Prayers of peace are sent across the world. The sculpture of Lord Buddha and Guru Rinpoche are kept inside central prayer hall of Buddhist temple. These monasteries are home to monks, lamas, and drakpas. Lama in Tibetan means superior master. The ordinary monks are called drakpa. Lamas are considered to be the spokesman of the deity. My trek was organized by Mr. Dhanaraj Gurung of Red Panda Tours and Travels. Welcome, sir. Thank you. Your trek to Goecha La Pass will take at least 8 days. The total distance of trek is a little more than 100 kilometers. We will cover about 10 to 15 kilometers every day. Best season to trek is March to May, October to November. Mr. Dhanaraj has been organizing trekking trips in Sikkim since 2006. He worked as a tourist guide for the past 20 years. Today is the beginning of my trek. I am going to touch these peaks soon. Wow! My trek through the Himalayas will take me through Kangchenjunga National Park, crossing the villages of Tshoka, Thengsing, Lamuney, and finally reach Goecha La. Another 10 days of hard trekking ahead. Yaks are the only method of transport along these tough mountain tracks. A yak can carry about 40 kilograms of load. Initial route is pretty much level with gentle ups and downs. Kangchenjunga National Park was established in 1977. It is deprived of human settlements except a few Lepcha settlements. The national park is home to white tiger, a mutant of the Indian tiger. This part of the track was destroyed by the earthquake, which happened a month ago.
Oh, को पानी गोगुन को पातै मा लाउन माया के गर्नु जातै मा रहेछौ बेसना ए रहेछौ बेसना चिन्जानै नहुने रहेछौ बेसना सुपारीलाई काटेर भङ्बुजा यो केटालाई
Thanks to our experienced guide, Ben, who could make out a way through debris. These tracks are very much used by the villagers to carry forest produce to the villages. This track was cut through by Tenzing Sherpa, a Nepali Indian mountaineer, to construct a base camp for mountaineering students of Himalayan Mountaineering Institute of Darjeeling. This track was used later for several Kangchenjunga expeditions. King's tomb Zhangbu Chu is what Lepchas, the earliest inhabitants of the land, called Kangchenjunga. It means bright, auspicious forehead peak. Though the origin of Lepcha community is not known, it is believed that they came from southeast China, crossing Assam and settled below Mount Kangchenjunga. They consider mountains holy and are great worshippers of Kangchenjunga. This is the last village on the trail, the Tibetan village of Tshoka, inhabited by about 10 families who fled from Tibet with Dalai Lama. I must stay here for a day to acclimatize myself with the thin air. Acute mountain sickness can occur at an altitude above 2,500 meters due to insufficiency of oxygen in this thin air. Early symptoms include headache, loss of appetite and vomiting. We must drink a lot of fluids. The mountains around are so vibrant with a thick layer of frost. Next day, we continued our trek to higher altitude. The low temperature during night has blessed with a little snowfall. Continuous snowfall hardens the lower layers of snow into ice. It is risky to walk on ice. It is very slippery and we don't know how deep is the snow cover. Colonialism and commercialization had a disastrous effect on the Himalayas. During the British regime, the large areas of Himalayan forests were replaced by several exotic species of trees brought from the west. Deciduous plants shed leaves during winter. These slots get filled with snow, imitating shapes of flowers and leaves. As we ascend, the pine trees give way to beautiful rhododendron trees. This bright flowering shrub, which grows at high altitudes, has attracted people from every part of the world. The British explorers of the early 19th century were the first to show this magical flower to the outside world. After that, a series of expeditions were conducted to the Himalayas to collect seeds and cuttings of the boldest and most beautiful specimens. After 2 days of hard trekking, we reached Petang. The sky has cleared up and the heat of the afternoon sun melts down most of the snow. Wow, beautiful. There is another 3 days of hard trekking to reach our final destination. After another day of trek, we reach Kokchurum. This river, Prechu River, originates from the southeast facing glacier of Mount Kangchenjunga. We cross this river a couple of times as we walk up along this river gorge to reach Tangsing. A partially frozen stream is the only source of water here. Cooks had a very difficult time grinding out water from ice.
Yeah.
Oh, it is slippery. After a day halt at Tangsing, we start to Lamuney. We follow the Prechu River Valley. The forest is mostly alpine, with short bushes and no trees. This portion of the trail is nearly flat. We set our camp at Lamuney. It is very cold. Each of us crawl into a couple of sleeping bags before sunset. Lamuni is known for dangerous strong winds. Lucas, is this tent gonna break? Reflection of early morning sun rays gives this golden color to the snow peaks. Today is the final day of our ascent. There are several myths surrounding this place. It is said that this is home to Kangchenjunga demon, a type of yeti. We follow the Prekchu River over the rough scramble of rocks to reach Samithi Lake. Water is so clear. This water must be very much purer than the packed drinking water available in the market. A few of the last places on our planet not disrupted by human intervention. We continue trekking over the scramble of rocks. The thin air and extreme low temperature makes it difficult to walk. Careful! Just head northwest. The loose boulders are not that friendly with my shoes. Mount Kangchenjunga range, the third highest peak in the world. The highest peak in India. Nothing seems equivalent to the grandeur of this beautiful snow peaks. This site is so worth thousands of prayer flags flapping in the winds. This is wonderful. No wonder the Lepcha people worship this mountain. This symbolizes the achievement of the hard work during the last 6 days. It's breathtaking and extraordinary. Oh, very strong winds. This is so lovely. The mountains are calling me. I prefer to stay back here.
Kayu, kayu, के खायो खसीले मेरो माया मेटिदेऊ मसीले रहेछौ बेसना हे रहेछ बेसना चिन्जानी नहुने रहेछौ बेसना खाउ खाउ पानी गोगुनको पातैमा लाउन माया के गर्नु जातैमा रहेछौ बेसना हे रहेछ बेसना चिन्जानी नहुने रहेछौ बेसना सुपारीलाई काटेर भङ्बुजा यो केटालाई हेरेर मन बुझा रहेछौ फेसना हे रहेछ फेसना चिन्जानी नहुने रहेछौ बेसना हेरेर मन बुझा रहेछौ फेसना हे रहेछ फेसलाई काटेर भङ्बुजा यो केटालाई हेरेर मन बुझा रहेछौ फेसना हे रहेछ फेसना चिन्जानी नहुने रहेछौ बेसना
यस कुछ थैंक यू.